So the first thing you want to do is download this file freshtomatoes.py from the instructor notes. Once you've downloaded it, make sure you save this file in the exact same folder as the Python file where we created all of these movie instances. Okay, so I'm going to begin to use the fresh tomatoes file and then call the function OpenMoviesPage. Now I know that this function OpenMoviesPage takes in a list or an array of movies. I do have a bunch of movies that I've created over here, but I do need to put them all in a list or an array. Let me do that next. So I will define an empty array or a list called movies. There it is. And to this list, I will add all of the movies I had created previously. So the first movie to add is Toy Story. Next one is Avatar. Next is School of Rock. The next one is Ratatouille. Its spelling is a little difficult. I think I got it. Next in line is Midnight in Paris. And the final one is Hunger Games. So there is our movies array. By the way, in case you need more information about lists or arrays, you can find a helpful link in the instructor notes. All right, now that I have a list of movies, I can give this list as input to the OpenMoviesPage function. Let me do that next. So I will provide movies as the argument to OpenMoviesPage function. There it is. Now, before I save and run this entire program, I know that I still haven't imported the file fresh tomatoes in my program. So I will scroll all the way up and import fresh tomatoes. Notice that this line of code will work only if the fresh tomatoes file is in the exact same folder as our current Python file. Okay, time to save and run this program. And there is our movie's website. If I click on any one of the links, its trailer will play.